On the topic of therapeutic innovation, please welcome Dorothy and Milton Flier, Professor of Biomedical Science and Genetics at Harvard Medical School, Steven McCarroll.
Hi, I'm Steve. Several years ago, I was given a chance to start a lab here at Harvard Medical School. With that came a chance to contribute to a scientific ecosystem like no other in the world, a discovery engine that works to transform possibilities for human health. But this engine is powered by people, people like you just heard in Rachel, brilliant, passionate students, postdocs, residents, fellows, who come and train here to unravel the mysteries of biology and to alter the course of human disease. This is an image from one story of so many from that kind of work here. Schizophrenia is a devastating illness, long in need of biological insight and innovative therapies. The medical treatments used to treat schizophrenia today have hardly evolved from drugs that were used in the 1960s, drugs that treat a single symptom while leaving the underlying disease untouched because its mechanisms are unknown. Enter Ashwin Sekar, an MD-PhD student at Harvard Medical School. Ashwin invented a new way of analyzing human genome data, a combination of molecular biology experiments he did in the lab, statistical approaches, and computer algorithms he wrote, to make forms of genetic variation that were previously invisible, visible to analysis. He then applied his approach to genetic data that from DNA that had been contributed from tens of thousands of schizophrenia patients from 30 countries all over the world. Ashwin's analysis taught us how the human genome exerts its strongest influence at a population level on risk of schizophrenia. He showed that this effect arises from overactive forms of a gene called complement component 4, C4 for short. This was surprising because C4 was considered an immune protein. More surprisingly, as shown here, we found the C4 protein present at synapses, the place where neurons contact other neurons in the nervous system. Nearby, at HMS, Ashwin found both Mike Carroll, an expert on the biology of the complement system, and Beth Stevens, who had discovered that other related complement proteins have a surprising other job in the brain, where they act as molecular tags that elicit the pruning or severing of connections between nerve cells. Together, this team, including also people in all three of our labs, showed that the C4 genes do this also, and that these overactive forms of the C4 genes do this excessively. This team's findings advanced our understanding of schizophrenia in a surprising direction. That knowledge, we hope, will make it possible to develop new kinds of therapies that might address the root causes of the illness. But this is just one of many ways that new approaches and technology platforms can be created and used to open new channels in our ability to listen to human biology. You're looking here at a movie of another one, a technology we call DropSeq. A long-standing need in science and medicine had been to better capture the biological information that's present but hidden inside of tissues. We know that information about disease processes must be locked up in the molecular states of the individual cells within tissues. But accessing this information was challenging for a very long time. These two Harvard Medical School postdocs, Evan Mikosko and Alon Klein, conceived and led efforts to develop technologies for analyzing tissues at the single cell level by encapsulating each individual cell in a tiny water droplet to be barcoded, to have its molecules barcoded with DNA for its own precision molecular analysis. You can see from this movie the speed at which individual cells can be packaged and barcoded and processed for analysis. This allows single cell sequencing of tens of thousands of individual cells at once. And they organized interdisciplinary teams across the Harvard Physics Department and the Broad Institute to actualize this vision at the level of droplet fluidics, physics, and data science. Today, this technology is helping scientists around the world to identify all of the cell types in the human body, to learn which genes are expressed in each cell population, and to identify the vulnerable cell populations in many diseases. This is my sister, who last year benefited from life-saving experimental medicine in a clinical trial for lymphoma. Many of you in the audience may know what it's like to experience firsthand the transformative power of experimental medicine in a tangible way. The experience induces profound gratitude and also awe at the promises and possibilities that biomedical research gives to people and their families. For all of us who do such research, such an experience also enhances a sense of urgency about getting everything done as quickly as we can. There's no waiting for the science to get there. We need to drive it forward and share it exuberantly so that advances can benefit people we know and love here and now. Thank you very much.